Next one is basically pervasive analytics. So what is pervasive analytics? This is an embedded dashboard into your master file or can be in your transaction screen. This particular analytic, pervasive analytics presents a real-time analytics which reflects a transactional activity as it happens, enables frontline employees to see relevant information to their job and at the moment that when they need this particular information. So the next demo I'm going to show is how we can easily build that dashboard. So what I did here is I have prepared my query, okay? So I'll be using my SAP Business One query generator. Okay, so I'll just click execute. So I'll just paste it here because I don't want you to see me typing here this particular codes, okay? So I'll just click execute here. So this is the result of my query. It's just only a simple one, whereby I'm just getting all the invoices information for a customer and what are the items they bought from me, what quantity, what sales, what gross profit, and which particular item group it belongs to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to save this particular query. So I just put in a sales demo. I'll save this particular query. So now that I have this query, I can go to my dashboard designer here, the icon for dashboard designer. So this dashboard designer source can be from the query that you have created, from the analytic view and calculation view, which is created in HANA technology. Okay, so but what I did just now was I just created this particular query called sales demo. So I'll just click on this particular query. Again, system will display the result of that particular query. So I'm going to use this query. So I'll just click OK. Then next step is for me to design my dashboard. So this is how I will present or how will I create my analysis, or how do I want to analyze this particular information. So let's say, for example, I want to analyze by group name, sales, and gross profit. As you can see, I can, using the power of HANA, I can instantly build this pervasive analytics. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to save this particular transaction or this particular dashboard as my sales demo. Then from here, I will add the links. So here, I'll be able to choose which or where in SAP Business One I can tag this pervasive analytics. So for this particular demo, I'll just go to my sales order here. Okay. Or maybe I'll just go to my inventory, my item master data here. Okay, I can, So I will just do a link to this particular item. So what is this link? Meaning, if I choose this particular item, and this particular analysis is by the item group, the system will show me relevant information only pertaining to this particular item group. So I'm going to click link, finish. Okay, so I just closed my dashboard. So now, if I go to my inventory, item master data, and I choose my item, as you can see on the right side, there is an analytics tab here. Usually, this is to shown for user-defined field, which is the standard SAP Business One. And for HANA version, you will have this additional tab called analytics here. So what I did in my query was I extract all information, all sales information pertaining to this particular item group. And this particular item belonging to IBM printers. Therefore, system displays to me the analysis or the current relevant information in comparison to my sales against my gross profit. If I move to the next item, let me just try to find another. Okay, so this particular item, HP color laser, belonging to HP printer. So system is smart enough to know to display relevant information for this particular item group. So this is just only a simple demonstration on how you can use this pervasive analytics. There are thousands of examples out there. You can do maybe when you create your sales order, this particular customer asks for a discount. Okay, so having this particular pervasive analytics here, maybe you have payment patterns, so you will be able to see on that particular transaction screen, you'll be able to see the payment pattern of this particular company. Therefore, on the spot, you can react whether you can give a discount or not to give a discount. Or maybe what is their inventory item sales analysis to you. Maybe are they growing their business to your company or not growing business to your company. So those are decision-making analysis which you can use in order for you to react fast when you face this particular request from your customer. Okay?